Good morning and welcome you all to this session of conduction and convection heat transfer. Now today we will solve one or two problems relating to one dimensional steady state heat conduction in cylindrical geometry, cylindrical wall, that is in a pipe of circular cross section. And a very interesting related problem is the critical thickness of insulation. So let us solve one or two problems just to have its applications. What yesterday also we solved a problem, that is in the last class. Now this problem is like this. There is a cylindrical container . The problem states like this. I am telling it, there is a cylindrical container, this is the axis, cylindrical container of radius r0, and the language of the problem is like that. Radioactive wastes are packed in a long thin walled cylindrical container. That means the radioactive wastes are packed. That means ultimately works as a solid cylinder type of thing. The radioactive wastes are packed in a long thin walled cylindrical container. The wastes generate thermal energy non-uniformly according to the relation that the volumetric energy generation rate at a point is given by Qg, Q0 into 1 minus R by R0 square, where Q0 and R0 are constants. Q0 and R0 are constant, that means it is varying with R. Which means there is a cylinder solid, because this wall, this a container, thin wall container is packed with the radioactive waste which generates energy in such a way. Though what they want, obtain an expression for the total rate at which the energy is generated, total rate of energy generation, and use this result to obtain an expression for the surface temperature TS. Surface temperature TS, that means surface temperature TS. So this is simplest again problem. First part is the total energy generation from the volumetric energy generation rate. So it is nothing but Qg is integral Qg dV. I usually represent volume as the V with a cut to distinguish it from velocity, where the convective heat transfer is associated with fluid mechanics, fluid flow, we use V as the velocity, that's why I use the V. This V is the volume, dV is the small elemental volume. That means if we consider an elemental area like this in the container, thin cylindrical elemental area, at a radius r, and the thickness of this is dr, for example, then this will be nothing but Qg. What will be the area, what will be the volume? 2 pi r l into dr. And if you do that, you get the expression this as pi Q0 R0 square by 2. Very simple. You put this, 2 pi L will come to out. So R dr R square by 2, that is R0 square by 2, because this now will be, this is for the entire volume. Now when I put it in terms of dr, it will be 0 to R0. So first term will be dr R dr, that is R0 square by 2, and second term will be R square by R0 square, R cube by R0 square dr. That means R0 4 and denominator R0 square, it will be again R0 square by 2. So ultimately you get pi Q0 R0 square by 2. This thing I am not doing in the class. So this is the expression. This is nothing. But what is the TS? Now to find TS expression at the surface temperature, you have to apply certain intelligence. That always we don't want a routine bulwark, that we have to find out the temperature distribution, heat generation is not required. Simply the gross energy balance, the total heat which is being generated, or total thermal energy which is being generated, must go out from the surface, because the problem is prescribed by a heat transfer coefficient H and a T infinity. This problem is prescribed that the container is immersed in a liquid or fluid that provides a uniform convection coefficient H and at a temperature T infinity. And express TS in terms of T infinity, H and Q0. So therefore, what we can write? We can write pi Q0 R square by 2 this is per unit length, so therefore this has to be this. So this is Qg per unit length. I am sorry, the result I have written, since I have not worked it out here, that's why this mistake is there, that Qg by L is pi Q0 R0 square by 2. So this L is there, so L is come, so L will come out, so Qg by L. So the total Qg is this. This must be equal to H into outer surface area, which will be twice pi R0 into L into Ts minus T. So therefore, from here we get TS. TS will be equal to T infinity, that is the ambient temperature, plus pi pi will cancel. So 4 will be there. That means Q0 R0 by 4H. Pi R0, Q0 R0 square, pi R0, Q0 R0 by 4H. I think it is okay. This is the problem. Next problem. Consider a pipe of inside radius R1 30 millimeter, outside radius R2 60 millimeter. This is a pipe of inside and outside radius, and thermal conductivity K1, that is the pipe material, is 10 watt per meter degree Celsius. The inside surface is maintained at a uniform temperature 350 degree Celsius, but some reason that there may be some hot fluid going inside. But the problem is prescribed this way, that inside surface temperature is 350 degrees Celsius. And the outside surface is to be insulated with an insulation material of thermal conductivity this. That means from this outside surface temperature, heat loss will be more to the ambient. Because of that, insulation is required. Then the problem states that an insulation is made with a material, insulating material of thermal conductivity K2, 0.1 watt per meter degree Celsius. Now the outside surface of the insulation material is exposed to an environment. This is the environment temperature T2, which is at 20 degrees Celsius. After the insulation, the insulating material is exposed with a heat transfer coefficient H2. That means the environment is at a temperature 20 degrees Celsius and it has an heat transfer coefficient 10 watt per meter square degree Celsius. Now we have to determine the thickness of insulation material required to reduce the heat loss by 25% of that of the uninsulated pipe exposed to the same environmental conditions. This is the problem. Problem is very simple. That means first we have to find out without the insulating material what will be the heat loss from a pipe of 30 millimeter inside radius and 60 millimeter outside radius, where the inside surface temperature is 350 and the ambient temperature is 20 degrees, going through conduction resistance and the convection resistance. And then we have to calculate the thickness of insulation. We have to consider another radius of insulation after putting the insulating material, and then we have to find out the again the rate of heat transfer considering that insulating material. That means adding another thermal resistance, conduction thermal resistance, and we will find out another convection resistance which will be reduced because of the increase in the surface area, as I have told, and that will be 0.75 of the without insulation because it will be reduced by 25%. So this is the problem. So there is heat transfer is 20% in this problem. So rest part is the mathematics. Okay. So let us solve this. Let us solve this. So this is the problem. You have a look. You can write in your own language, not exactly all the words have to be written. Okay. This is the concentric cylinder. This is R1. This is R2. This is T1. This is T2, which is exposed to the same environmental condition, HT infinity. Now, if this be the cylinder, the first now heat transfer without the insulation, Q without uninsulated, uninsulated pipe equals to, we know that this is the potential difference which we have done, so we don't have to deduce it, ln. If you want to deduce it, you can deduce it, but if you want to remember it, you can write straightforward ln. Sometimes certain things have to be remembered, I tell you, because the time is short. We will try to give problems in the examinations where very, very less amount of thing you have to remember, almost nil. But sometimes for this problem, again to generate this, then this is the conduction resistance twice pi L K1. I tell it K1. The nomenclature is like that. K1 is this in the problem, which is the thermal conductivity of the cylinder material, plus the convective resistance when the pipe is the bare pipe without any insulation, then it is H into twice pi R1 R2. Very good. Twice pi R2. Tell loudly. Twice pi R2 into L. Very good. Okay. Now, when we have the insulating material. This is the insulating material. This is the insulating material with the thermal conductivity K2, and we consider, which we have to find out, we take this radius to be R3. That means insulating material is provided up to a radius of R3, and we have to find out this R3. Then what is the Q insulated? Q insulated pipe equals to, they are subjected to same potential difference because the environment remains same and the inside surface remains same, T1 minus T infinity. Very simple problem. Heat transfer, until and unless you come to convection, heat transfer things are very simple. As far as this your undergraduate level material is concerned, however, conduction contains high level mathematics afterwards, three-dimensional conduction, unsteady state, T1 minus T infinity. Now, in this case, there are two conduction resistance, one due to cylinder R2 by R1, cylinder material, twice pi LK1. Another one, ln, due to, this is also a solid material, conduction through this thick insulation, which is extending from R2 to R3. So therefore, it is ln R3 by R2, and here it is twice pi LK2. And finally, the convection resistance, 1 by H twice pi R3 into L. Okay? 1 by H twice pi R3 L. I am sorry, R3, smaller. Okay? Now, according to the problem, Q insulated 0.75 Q uninsulated. Q insulated pipe so if you make this, that this equal to 3/4 of this Q1 insulated, T1 minus T infinity will cancel, then you can write this after putting, substituting the values. Now I am writing the values here, T1, what is the, what are values? R2 is, what is that, 60 millimeter, that means 0.06 meter. R1 is 30 millimeter. What is R1? 30 millimeter. 60 millimeter. 0.6. I am sorry. 6 meter. This is 0.3 meter. 0.6 or 0.06? I was 06. It was all right earlier. 0.06 and 0.03 meter. 0.06, yes, I am writing the value, 0.06 meter, 60 millimeter, divided by 10 to the power 3, 0.38 meter. What is K1? K1 is 10 watt per meter degree Celsius, and K2 is what? 0.1 watt per meter degree Celsius. What is T1? T1 is 350 degrees Celsius. What is T infinity? T infinity is 20 degrees Celsius. But incidentally, this T1, T infinity will not be required to solve the problem. but a problem gives data like that. And H, which is very, very important, which is 10 watt per meter square, that it is unit, and at the same time this is given, that Q insulated is 0.75. Now if you put this value, finally you will have a relationship like this. This denominator is totally calculated because R2L, K1, everything I know. So this becomes finally a shape like this. I am telling the final step, 0.0693 plus 10 after some simplification. It is only a simple algebra, ln R by 0.06 plus 0.1 by R is equal to 4 by 3 into 1.736. Actually, this 1.736 is this value that I can tell you. 1 by 2 pi L into that, I give you a hint that this value, if you calculate, actually 2 pi L will cancel from both the sides, 1.76. So this denominator, this resistance, is 1 by 2 pi L into 1.76. So this is a tedious calculation. So after writing this, Q insulated 0.75 this, and if you write this is equal to 0.75, then cancel it, 80% credit is there. But don't take this advantage. This is because I am telling you, it is not only the marks that matters. I can give you marks, but you have to develop your ability of completing the work. Finally, when you will go to the shop or to the actual field, then you have to deliver things, deliver the final product. So if you say that this, because at certain stage, you cannot tell, okay, my assistants will do it. If you go up, then it will be possible. But at some stage, you have to work. So to definitely, I am telling both the things, that I am not telling that final answer is the only thing that you will get marks, otherwise you will get zero. No, you may get 80% credit if you just write this, even up to this you don't solve it. But this type of problem may not come where the iterative solution is there. So there is an iterative solution because R this fashion. So R comes out to be 64.3 millimeter. That means the thickness, insulation thickness, is equal to 4.3 millimeter. Insulation thickness is 4.3 millimeter. 4.3 millimeter. Now, my intention to tell it that up to this, okay, you can get 80% credit, but you have to complete the work that will help you in developing the skill to complete a thing. Okay, so this is a simple problem. Just application of this principle of critical thickness of insulation. Now I will discuss about the steady one-dimensional heat transfer through spherical geometry. Spherical wall. Now, discussing different types of geometry gives you additional information. At the same time, brushing up again and again the fundamental equations which you are using. So, this will be built in your memory. Now, spherical geometry, the most simple example is a spherical shell, just like this, a reactor, spherical reactor. You consider a spherical reactor. All these deductions are also the problems. Spherical reactors, which is spherical in nature with radius R1 and R2. Spherical. Now, same thing, that's why I'm telling that, recapitulating, the how to write the heat balance here, again, you take a shell, spherical shell. Only difference is that it is spherical in nature. In case of cylinder, it is cylindrical in nature. In case of plain wall, it is plain in nature. That is the only difference. But our problem, tackling the problem is same, that let us consider at a radius r, we have this shell which is having a thickness delta r. And the same thing, that the heat which is coming here qr, and the heat which is going out, this is here, I will not draw, this will be overlapping here, for example, qr. And this is going from the outer face of the cell, qr plus del r. And again, small r plus del r. And again, we consider a volumetric heat generation per unit volume defined at each and every point in the spherical cell, this material, which extends from r1 to r2. This is the final r2. Okay, r1 to r2, this is r2. And we take an element at radius r of delta r, and qr is the heat flux, heat, total heat coming into this elemental volume, and qr plus del r going out, and qg is the volumetric internal thermal energy generation. The same equation again and again, qr plus delta r must be equal to qr plus qg into what is ar. Ar is the area and delta r, and always ar is the area which is perpendicular to the direction of heat flow, perpendicular to the r direction. That's all. And now if we expand in Taylor series qr plus delta r, then we get ddr of, then this will be qr plus ddr of qr into delta, neglecting the higher order terms that we have done enough in plane and cylindrical geometry. That means qr delta r minus qg ar delta r is 0. Again and again, your practice. So ddr of qr, r direction, minus qg ar is 0. Now Fourier heat conduction equation, ddr of, that is heat flux, heat transfer at any direction is heat flux, into the area, minus qg ar is 0. Again and again I am doing the same thing. Now this is not the Fourier heat conduction equation, sorry, I am just splitting it, heat flux into area. Then Fourier heat conduction equation, here heat flux is minus k ar dt dr, because heat flux is minus k dt dr, minus qg into ar is 0. Take this minus sign out, so that ddr of k ar dt dr plus qg into ar. Why I am writing this again and again, Professor Shroom is writing this, is because if a student can do this thing well, he cannot miss a problem in one dimensional steady state heat conduction. So far up to this equation, this is the most generalized equation, I have not imposed any geometrical constraint. So this is a direction of heat flow. If it is a plane area, then it will be x ax qg ax. Plane area may vary with normal area, may not vary with normal area, we have done it earlier. It may be cylindrical area where r is the direction of heat flow. So therefore, if you can remember this equation, or it can immediately derive this equation from the conservation of energy, things are over. Now for any condition, if you consider k is independent of, now what are the generalized, k is temperature dependent, maybe ar may be dependent on r, it is a one dimensional direction of heat flow. K QG may be constant, may be a function of R, or may be zero. That means there may not be any internal energy generation. So if you take the most simple case where K is not dependent on temperature, A does not depend on the path of heat flow, this happens only in the plain area. Okay? And there is no heat generation, then it gives simple solution that d square t dr square 0. That means dt dr is constant. So if you can arrive this thing, everything is done. Now spherical geometry, now it becomes application. Ar is 4 pi r square. Put that and take k constant. So what will be the result? 4 pi r square and k constant. This becomes ddr of r square dt dr plus qg r square by k is 0. Simply. So from here I can go anywhere and any problem. If everything varies with their independent variable, okay, then it is a problem of little complicated mathematics, nothing else. So now if I solve this for a simple case without heat generation, what do I get? Please tell me, what do I get without heat generation? Do it. This is a problem, tutorial problem type of thing. Without heat generation, when QG equal to 0, then ddr of r square dt dr 0. That means dt dr is some constant by r square. First integration. Second one is t is, now if you integrate this, minus c1 r plus c. Now it becomes a very routine and to some extent boring, but as a student you have to go through this part also. So it is not challenging at this moment. At boundary condition, r is equal to r1, t is equal to t1. At r is equal to r2, t is equal to t. And if you do it meticulously, then what you get is if you solve this with the boundary condition, you get the temperature distribution like this, T1 minus T divided by T1 minus T2. Straightforward, you get 1 by R1 minus 1 by R. R is the current radius where the temperature is T, 1 by R1 minus 1 by R. So this type of function will come. Next part is to find out the heat transfer rate at any radius r. It is equal to minus k into area 4 pi r square into dt dr at r is equal to, sorry, not r, at any r, because I am finding out at any current radius. This is AR, 4 pi R square minus K dT dr. Now what is dT dr? 4 pi R square. Now dT dr is, there is a minus sign, 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. So there will be a minus sign. So minus dt dr is 1 by minus 1 by r. That means 1 by r square. Minus will be there. sorry. That means this r square and r square will cancel out. 4 pi r square, am I dt dr is okay. Minus 4 pi k divided by and t1 minus t2. Yes, I have done a mistake. T1 minus, meticulously you do, dt dr is minus, this is a minus sign, t1 minus t2 into minus 1 by r will be 1 by r square. So therefore this minus minus will be, therefore 4 pi k 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2 into t1 minus t2. You can check whether you are doing a mistake or not. If you remember the final formula, that it will be again the potential difference minus a divided by the resistance whose formula is this one. R2 minus R1 divided by 4 pi k R1 R2. That means this is the conduction resistance, which is ln R2 by R1 by twice pi Lk. Sometimes the memory helps this way, that you can check, oh, this is not coming, somewhere I have done some mistake. Another thing, by your concept, when you are finding out Q at any cross-sectional area, where the area is a function of R or function of X, that will be cancelled finally with the dt dr expression, because Q, total heat transfer, has to be independent of the direction, because at all sections, same. Clear? With heat generation, how to find out? With heat generation, to find out the temperature distribution, you have to solve this equation, ddr of r square dt dr, which we arrived earlier. We discarded this term, considering Qg to be 0, Qg r square by k. Now, with heat generation, but Qg to be uniform, that means constant, volumetric heat generation at any location is independent of the coordinate, not dependent on the direction along the heat flow. That means Qg is constant, not the function of R. In that case, it will be again a very simple integration, considering Qg constant, and you can find out. Should I do it, or you will be able to find it out? What is the expression you can find it out? That ddr of R square dt dr is, that means you take this, that side, then you first integration R square dt dr is minus Qg R cube by 3k. Am I right? Then dt dr is Qg R by 3k. Next is plus some integration constant will come. Then next will be T is equal to minus Qg, this will be again R. So this will be ultimately R square divided by 6k plus C1 R plus C2. Before writing the boundary condition, now this problem is not a spherical cell. Yes, just I am solving as a mathematician. A differential equation, I am provoked, tempted to solve it. But what is the practical problem? There is a spherical container packed with material. That means this is a solid spherical container whose radius is R0. And the problem is prescribed that thermal energy is generated at a rate of Qg per unit volume, which is constant throughout, and I have to keep the surface temperature Ts constant. Well, and there is an ambient T infinity which is not very important in determining the temperature distribution. So this is a solid sphere. So the boundary condition requires that at same thing at R is equal to R0, T is equal to Ts, and because of the symmetry dT dr is 0 at R is equal to 0 center, which means that C1 has to be 0. C1 cannot exist because there should not be any term 1 by R which will give a discontinuity at the center. And moreover, dT dr is 0 at R is equal to 0. And first boundary condition Ts gives C2 is equal to Ts plus Qg R0 square by 6k. So therefore, we can write the expression as plus Qg R0 square by 6k. This is so simple that repetition is. And if you find out the heat transfer at any section Q, what the expression is? Q is equal to 4 pi r square minus k a. Again and again doing means this will be memorized. Q is equal to at any r minus k into 4 pi r square area into dt dr. What is dt dr? 2r. R0 square, R0 square will cancel. That means Qg by 3k. Qg by 3k. 2r. 2r. Qg by 3k. 2r. That means 2, 2 will cancel 3k and this will be into r. That means and there will be a minus sign, so minus r. So if you take care of this, it will be k into 4 third pi r cube into qg, and this kk will cancel, sorry, this k will not come. So why I have written that? I want to show you here with heat generation at any radial location, heat transfer rate is a function of R because it is changing because of the generation of local generation of thermal energy. It is not constant. Without Qg, it is constant. But at R is equal to R0, this value must match with the total gross energy balance, total heat generation. This is total heat generation. That's all. Here also, if you add insulating material in the spherical cell, the concept of critical radius of insulation will come. And you derive it, it is your task that I will not do. The critical radius of insulation for spherical wall is R critical is 2k by h. That means if I have a spherical cell or a spherical wall, whatever you call spherical cell, and the problem is prescribed like this. This is R1, the outer radius, and it has a temperature of T1. Then if I put insulation where this is the radius RC, the critical radius, this is insulation. In the similar way we derive for cylindrical coordinate, we can derive the heat transfer rate will maximize, initially increase and then maximize when R critical is 2k by h. This is the conduction resistance. You will have to consider the convection resistance. Convection resistance, that means if a sphere is a spherical cell is subjected to convection and the temperature is given of the ambience. I am giving you hints that how to solve this problem. So this is the conduction resistance. this is the conduction resistance, but we have to give the convection resistance, that if a, before solving this problem, you must have this thing in your mind, that if a spherical, like the same cylindrical one, if this is R1, this is R2, and we are provided with temperature T1 and T infinity and H, then Q is equal to T1 minus T2 divided by the conduction resistance, that is R2 minus R1, as we have generated, that is 4 pi k R1 R2 plus 1 by H 4 pi R2 square. This is because heat is, Q is T1 minus, if I consider this surface temperature is T2, which is not prescribed by, but I can write this way, R2 minus R1 divided by 4 pi k R1 R2, and the same heat is flowing in series under steady state with T2 minus T infinity divided by 1 by H. Rather, it is better to write this fashion, it will be understandable by the definition of H, H into 2 pi R2 L into T2 minus T infinity, T2 minus T infinity. That means again it is a series problem. That means series network is like this, conduction resistance similar to that cylindrical and convection resistance, T1, T2, T infinity. So this is R conduction, this is R convection, this term. So therefore this is R. So this series thing, similar to that of cylindrical geometry, you have to take care of, and then you have to differentiate to find out this critical radius. Very good, T2 minus T infinity, correct, very good. Anything? Okay? Any question? Any question? Okay, all right.